the language of prejudice and the power of the language of prejudice. It's called prejudice. In our modern free-spoken society, there is a word that we still hold taboo. A word with a terrible history of being used to abuse, oppress and subdue. Just six seemingly harmless letters arranged in a way that will form a word with more power than the pieces of metal that are forged to make swords. A couple of G's, an R and an E, an I and an N. Just six little letters, all jumbled together, have caused damage that we may never mend. And it's important that we all respect that if these people should happen to choose to reclaim the word as their own, it doesn't mean the rest of you have a right to its use. So never underestimate the power that language imparts. Sticks and stones may break your bones, but words can break hearts. A couple of G's, cheese, unless you've had to live it. An R and an E, even I am careful with it. An I and an N, in the end, it will only offend. Don't wanna have to spell it out again. Only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. So listen to me, if you care for your health, you won't call me ginger unless you ginger yourself. Yeah, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. But fucking with the G word is just not on. If you're a gingerphobe and you don't like us, we will stand up to the fight if you want to fight us. But if you cut yourself, you might catch gingivitis. So maybe you should shut your funky mouth.